in this relaxing morning run, I want to talk to you about the biggest breed from Scotland. And this breed has been known under several names, also giving you some insight about the breed. It was even known under the name Irish Wolfhound for a time, but it has been perfected in the name it currently has, which is a deerhound, also known as a Scottish deerhound. Nowadays, the Irish Wolfhound and the deerhound are two separate breeds. If you would put them next to each other, the Irish Wolfhound is a lot more bulkier because it also, as its name implies, was perfected for hunting wolves. So that meant a stronger type of dog that has a little bit less speed needed, but still very fast. And the deerhound, as the name implies, was perfected for hunting deer. So that means a type of dog that has less fighting abilities, but more speed. Also, the Irish Wolfhound is a little bit bigger still than the deerhound, which is already a giant. So, the Irish deerhound was also known as a rough-coated greyhound, which does it a lot more justice. So, if you look at the greyhound silhouette and then add a little bit more coat and a little bit more bulk, just a little bit, it has a little bit more fighting abilities, because for a normal greyhound, a deer is too big a quarry to handle. So what was the purpose of this deerhound? It was known under several names, but it's now a completely separate breed. The purpose of this breed was to chase the deers. It was also used in another quarry, as history implied. There's also a Russian type of wolfhound, the Borzoi, the Russian wolfhound, which also has that running the dog appearance, also the rough coat, and was used for similar purposes as Irish wolfhound, but not that bulky. So it gives you some insights that even a deerhound could be, was less successful than the Irish wolfhound because of the less bulk and also a lot less fighting abilities, but could be used in a certain way to hunt other quarry, including wolves. The Irish wolfhound could be it could be bred if you would put like 75% of greyhound and like 25% of Irish wolfhound, that you would select for that rough coat by breeding multiple generations. That's the appearance. So more greyhound, a rough greyhound, than Irish wolfhound in appearance. Also, it has a lot of the speed. It's not as fast as the greyhound is, which is the fastest dog on earth, but it's even bigger. So it helps a little bit with the paw length and also the mass to use for top speed. It is a dog with a good endurance. It's a gentle giant. As a general, those long dogs, running dogs, have a gentle disposition towards humans. Also, it's not a guard type of dog. It may bark like a watchdog, but it's not a dog. Although it's very big and can detriment those with ill intent, it's not a good dog to guard yourself with. So keep it in mind, if you look for a dog that is big enough to protect you, could probably better look elsewhere. It is a gentle dog that needs its time running free in this fields like this, and if you can offer it something to hunt, also be noted that there are deerhounds that are used for show, which is the majority. That also implied why the breeds were separated further, and that the one is more mass, the wolfhound, and the other one is more of a running dog, the deerhound. But there's also working stock, and there's not that much known about working deerhound, but they're still around. They're also used a lot in lurcher crosses, so crosses with other running dogs, for example, to put even more gray in them. Still have the fighting ability a little bit of the deerhound, but adds a little bit more speed and likeness of the feet from the greyhound and other crosses. Often also in those lurcher types of dogs, there's a little bit bull introduced to give them even more fighting ability. And the deerhound has a good rough coat which protects it against the damage of brushes and other things. It was such a good deer hunter, but in the past, only you, if you were nobility, you could have one and use one. Goedemorgen. Hoi hoi. Hey. So for example, if you would want to use a dog like the deerhound, you need to be at least an Earl. That also put it in dire water, because when the nobility just imploded in the 1800s, so did this type of dog. It was also hated because a lot of people wanted to do to have a running type of dog and catch their own quarry, but were not allowed, and they only had like terrier type of dogs or other dogs that were not able to run. And sometimes their even their feet needed to be destroyed a little bit, because they would remove, for example, a toe that they were not able to run as fast. Also tails were docked so that they could not alter the direction that fast. Were pitiful times. So when the nobility then imploded, even the remaining dogs had a hard life, so they had to be kept secretly to survive. This type of dog has been recreated, so to say, but especially just using those dogs that are still left to make the current day deerhound. Deerhound pups often, like Irish wolfhound pups, become the first thing that you see with them when they are pups. They have a light coat, often it's a brindle type, short coated, and when they mature, their coat does as well. So it can take to over a year for the mature coat completely shows. And then it's funny to see the father and mother, and then there's, for example, two quite big pups that still have their quite flat coat, and then the parents already have that really rough coat. Coming back to lurches, another way that some people get this rougher coat is by crossing in collie or other types of dogs. And also the Borzoi, it is said it's a collie type or Leica type was bred into it. It gave it the rougher coat. It's a sign of beauty to see a running dog run, especially greyhounds or whippets. Those are the two breeds I like the most from the running dogs, also very fast. But I also really like a good lurcher, and to put it plain and simple, you could see the deerhound as one of the fastest and biggest lurchers there is. Which gives you the ability of a stronger type of dog with the speed of a running dog. And because they are so big, they're very fast. Also the working type of deerhound often carries a little bit more greyhound than the normal types. So that they are interbred and selected for working ability, and are just known as smooth-coated and rough-coated greyhounds to some. The deerhound is a nice, strong type of lurcher that gives your family a nice docile giant. Also, greyhounds are known to be lazy inside, so don't think because you have a big, very fast dog that it will just run over the entire home all the time. Whippets are more like that, a little bit more bouncy, but even whippets are quite relaxed as compared to some terriers. For example, this is my terrier. This is an English type terrier, also known as the black fell terrier, smooth coated, as you can see. They're also rough coated and other coats, like longer coats. It's also known as the Patterdale. This is an entirely different breed of hunting breed as compared to the deerhound. Deerhound relies on its size and speed. This relies on its relative size because it brings a lot of strength for the smallness of its chest, and can also the chest is very flexible, so it can manage to get into small crevices, and at that time it's not going to nip at the quarry, but just try and hold, and if possible just deal with it. Its quarry is especially foxes of the Patterdale region, but also used on badger or other quarry, sometimes even up to hawks, which are also known as wild swines for some, and in some places also feral pigs, of course, so the more domesticated cousin that went feral again, and also used on big things like big type of rats like the nutria, which is like a beaver rat type of rat, so very the size of a beaver or even more, and still a rat, also the tail of a rat, and once used for its coat, which is very woolly and has been escaping coat for farms, but also on the raccoon, even the big raccoons, and raccoon dog. So two different species that both look like a raccoon. One is a real raccoon type of creature, and the other one is more of a separate canine. Also not that much related to the fox, also not that related to the wolf, but a separate canine class known as raccoon dog. It comes from Asia into Russia, whereas the raccoon comes from the States, and both were also used as fur sources, but and they then escaped, but especially the raccoon dog just made its pass and thought that its territory could be become bigger to move the border every time. Nice bird of prey. See, he's flying. I think it's a falcon that's going to sit there and wait to see if it can hit something up. It also looks that something is there. Perhaps he already killed something. We will check it out. So this is a terrier type of dog that goes below ground, but it's also used above ground for other quarry. Deerhounds are also good killers of foxes, especially when the fox just jumps. So for example, a terrier is in and then it bolts out of its lair. Then the deerhound type of dog, running type of dog, will try to catch up and dispatch it. Sometimes they're also used for pulling, but then they are often crossed with some bull, like, to make them a bit more strong and more capable of handling. I hope you liked this video. Have a nice day.